Welcome back to the One API channel. In previous video, we saw the open source SYCLomatic tool, the open source version of the One API migration tool from Cuda to SYCL. But how does the converted code really looks like? What portion of the code will run on the CPU and which on the accelerator? How much manual work is required? There are many real examples, but I'd like to show you a really nice one from CodePlay. Here is the link to the GitHub. The algorithm is n-body simulation, basically simulating the gravitational forces between many particles and calculating their position or location in space. The code is not very complex, but it's a nice demonstration. CodePlay engineers were able to run it on a CUDA device, as you can see here, then convert the code automatically to SYCL, so now it can run on many devices from many vendors. But they also took the SYCL code and ran it back on the same GeForce RTX system and got even better results than the CUDA code. Well, this will not happen all the times, but it is nice. Let's try to run it. I'll leave you the instructions below. I have the One API base toolkit installed. Let's make sure to set up the environment. Let's make sure I have the compatibility tool, the SYCLomatic. It's here. I will need the Clang compiler, which is not here. Let's find it and add it to the path. Now it's here. No way around it. We need to install the NVIDIA toolkit. I already got it. Install the prerequisites as described in the GitHub page. All set. Now clone the repository and get in. Under source, you have the CUDA files, and let's copy them to source underscore SYCL, and I'm running the migration tool. I'm getting a bunch of warnings, but no errors. You'll see these warnings in the code, and under DPCT output, I'm getting the SYCL files. You can see all the warnings inside. Most are related to error code. This one is a different rounding mode, but no big issues. Let's compare the two files. On the left, we have the original CUDA code, and on the right is the new SYCL code. I've removed the comments so it will be a little bit cleaner, and instead of the CUDA library, we are taking the SYCL one, and here is the actual kernel. And you can see how we get SYCL device and a queue and implement the kernel. The rest is mainly error checking. That looks different, and memory copy. Beside that, it looks pretty clean. Let's build the solution. I'll be using the build dpcpp script under scripts. Need to make sure the CUDA support is off. Copy the SYCL files to the right place and build. And it is running. Kernel processing time is around 40 milliseconds. This is running on my gamer Nuke system CPU and the kernel on the GPU. Pretty cool. So think about that. A few minutes ago, I had this CUDA code, and now I have the same code in SYCL, and I can run it on my CPU, on my GPU, and many other devices. You can even run this SYCL code back on the NVIDIA device it was coded for. Subscribe, send me feedback, enjoy. Thank you.